what's up? It's the Nerf Herder, and I've got my Retro Pop box for December 2015. Now, if you remember, I got the 1960s for November, and they bumped me up to the 1970s for December, and I was, believe it or not, and this dates me, I was alive during the 70s, although I don't really, you know, have much of a recollection of it, because, you know, I was just a wee little guy. But, so I am kind of familiar with the decade, although, you know, none of my real memories were forged until the 80s. So, yeah, let's crack it open and see what kind of 70s goodies we got. I'll show this real quick. There's a little sticker on top of some tissue paper that says, "Can you dig it?" From, what is that? I can't even think of it right now. The Warriors? Is that from the Warriors? Or is that just like, "Can you dig it, brother?" I don't know. Whatever. But, yeah. So that was that. Let's start out with the shirt because it's right on top. And it is blue, and it is, oh, yeah, it's like Rock'em Sock'em Robots, except that it is, from Rudolph, I think it was. So, like, is that Jack Frost versus, the Sun Guy? Man, you know, I didn't watch that this year. Normally, I'm all about these, the kids' movie. Knock His Frost Off is what it's called. But I can't remember what the red guy's name is. He's the, you know, like the summer guy. And, you know, I'm a little embarrassed by that because I'm all about these shows. But, check it out. Very cool looking. I love that. I loved watching the old, you know, like, claymation, whatever they were called, you know, Christmas specials, and, Rock'em Sock'em Robots, you know, I mean, they remade those. You can actually go buy those today, but, very cool. All right, next up, we got, oh, ha, 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 I'm like, how is that sticking? So we got a keychain, and it's a disco ball, and it says, "Boogie Oogie Oogie," you know. So, you know, you can get your boogie on and, you know, John Travolta style. I'm not really gonna do that, but, you know. So, yeah, kind of like the Saturday Night Fever type thing. It's a keychain, but, yeah, it's kind of cool. And it was stuck to some DC Villains magnets. Now, I love these way better than pins. Because, you know, I don't wear pins, like, on my clothing or anything like that. But I stick the crap out of the magnets all over, like, my fridge and stuff like that. So, love the magnets. Very awesome. And we got the Joker. We got Harley Quinn. We got, looks like, Catwoman and Two-Face right there. So, it's all the villains, the DC villains, which, you know, I like much better than the DC heroes, to be honest with you. So, very cool. Alright, next we got, "You Come to a Closed Door. If you decide to open it, roll a d20 and flip this card over. Note, attribute and skill modifiers do not apply." So this is like a, well, it's a door thingy. And it's like D&D. Which I did actually used to play back in the day. And it did come with a 20-sided die right there. Which is totally awesome. This was made by Retro Pop Box. It's got a Retro Pop Box fun fact on it. So in a departure from popular traditional military-themed war games, role-playing games are RPGs. By allowing players to assume the roles of individuals rather than groups, armies, it also concentrated on storytelling to immerse the players in their environment. RPGs, especially Dungeons & Dragons from the 70s, created an interaction between players to solve problems and overcome obstacles to advance through the adventures. Decisions and outcomes were determined through game pieces such as cards, dice, and in the case of live-action role-playing games, acted scenes. By the early 2000s, there was estimated to be over 20 million active RPG players, contributing to over $1 billion in retail sales of books and game-related products. So it's got all the different things, all the outcomes of if you what you roll there at the door. So yeah, if you only roll a one, you're left charred and smoking heap of ash because there was a fire trap on the door. And you can only get in if you roll a 20. So it's clever. It's, you know, it brings me back to a different time, you know, before video games did all of the role-playing for you. You know, we sat there with our books and our little sketch pads and our manuals and whatnot and played some D&D, man. So that's cool. It's simple, but I like it, and it takes me back. Next up, we got a coaster set. And they have it, like, make it look like it's on clearance because it's got, like, a clearance tag. And it says, don't let water rings on your swanky laminate mahogany side table ruin your mojo. To get in good with the ladies, always use protection. That's why our coasters are a safe bet. So, there's a margarita and a pink pussycat. And probably some other... Yeah, there's four in there. So that's clever. They're coasters, which I don't even have a coffee table. But I will find a use for them for sure. I like the things on the package. I think it's clever. And yeah, so there you go. But, you know something? That was all... Let go. That's in the box. Alright, so let's recap this. We got the Ode to Roleplay door hanger right there. We got the Kitsch on the Rocks cocktail coasters. We got the Disco Ball keychain. We got the Villains magnets right there. And then the... Oh, it's the Miser. Miser versus Miser. Exclusive t-shirt. So it was Miser 10 Below or Miser 101. Man, I can't believe I didn't know that. So it's the Rock'em Sock'em Robots and the Misers, and very awesome. That's the Retro Pop Box. If you don't know about Retro Pop Box, it's a nostalgia based subscription box. So you pick your era, 60s, 70s, or 80s. And they send you an experience that kind of takes you back down memory lane. And things aren't necessarily from, like, it's not a vintage item you get. It's inspired by that period of time. Like the shirt and the D&D thing and everything like that. The service runs $25 a month shipped. And if you want to check them out, I got a link down below there. And next month... For January, I should be getting the 80s because they wanted to display, like, all the different eras. And then I believe that will be the end of my freebies from them. So, yeah, check them out. Retro Pop Box. And that is all. All right, and as always, thank you for watching. If you like this video, go ahead and hit that like button. Subscribe to my channel. Visit my website, www.thenerfherderblog.com. Check it out. It's awesome. I'm talking like this just because I want to, and I'm doing it on purpose. So, that is all. Till my next unboxing. Goodbye.